Thank you for watching, and in this video we are going to cover the combine command in direct editing tool in SOLIDWORKS. So combine commands allow us to add, subtract, or find the common part between individual bodies. So as right now you can see on our screen, we have a part here. So if I use the combine command, we need to build another part. So right now we have already a sketch 4 here on the screen, as you can see. So what I can do is I can just go into the features, and then I can go into the revolve, boss, or base section. Okay, and then you can see I need to choose the axis of revolution. So I'm gonna select this axis of revolution. Okay, so don't forget to uncheck this merge results, because we want to have two individual bodies. So I'm just gonna uncheck this, and then let's click the green check mark. So you can see into the solid bodies, we have two bodies. One is this one and one is the upper one. So right now we have two bodies. So let's go into the direct editing tool. And then what we can do is, you can see in the ribbon section, there is an option combine. So I'm gonna go into the combine. And then into the combine, there are three different kind of operations. The first one is to add, and then second, subtract, and third one is to find the common part between individual bodies. So let's say I want to add them first. So as we already did in the previous video, so what we can do is we just need to check add, then bodies to combine. We need to select two bodies which we want to combine. So I'm gonna select this body, and then I'm gonna select this body, and then I need to click the green check mark. So in this way, both bodies are combined. As you can see into the solid bodies, there is only one body which is called combine one. So, but we can just delete this combine. And then still we are back. We have two different bodies, first one and second one. So again, I would like to go back into the direct editing and into the ribbon section into combine. Okay, the second option is subtract. So I want to subtract. So now I need to select two bodies. One is main body and one is the body which I want to subtract. Suppose I want to select the main body, this one, and then I want two bodies to subtract. I need to select this body. And then I'm gonna click the green check mark. Okay, so this is the body which I have after subtracting the inner body. So maybe this is not very clear. So let's go into the section view. And into the section view, I would like to go to the top plane. Yes. So let's increase it to upside. And as you can see now here, the inner body is subtracted from this main body. So this looks awesome. So sometimes if we are using our parts for molding, so this kind of design we can use in molding easily. There are some other functions to build your parts for molding, but this is also one of them. So I'm just gonna exit the sketch, and then I'm gonna delete this combine because I want to apply the common one as well. Again, we have two bodies, and then again I am gonna go into the combine. So let's do common this time. So we need to have a common part of both individual bodies. So I need to select the bodies. First one is this one, and I need to select second one. This is the second part. And then I'm gonna click the green check mark. Look, in this way we will have a common part of both individual bodies. So most of the time I use combine just to add individual bodies, but the subtract and common is also pretty handy, I would say. So, but mostly when I have a different individual parts and I want to bring them and I want to mate them, so I can just combine. This is what I really like, I would say. So, but the other commands like subtract and common, they are also very useful. So I would say like this was a really powerful command in direct editing tool. So in the next video, we are gonna cover the split in direct editing tool. And that's all for today's video. Thank you so much for watching, and I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, don't forget to hit that like button and subscribe to our channel for more videos like this one. And if you are a serious SOLIDWORKS learner, then don't forget to check the course link in the description. Thank you. Sorry for distraction, but if you think my videos are helpful for you, or if you are a serious SOLIDWORKS learner, I am gonna highly recommend you can go into the description of this video, where you can find my course link, in which I have over 10 hours of videos in which I explain each and every command in a detailed way. Thank you.